안녕하세요. 안차키입니다. Welcome to yet another edition of Let's Speak Korean, where we learn the Korean language the fun and easy way. Let's say hello to 지승현 선생님, who is here with us to help us through our lesson. 안녕하세요, 선생님.
안녕하세요. 안녕하세요, 지승현입니다. 다시 만나서 반갑습니다. I'm very happy to see you in this lesson.
All right, before we go straight to our new lesson, let's go for a quick review of what we learned in our last lesson with 선생님.
In our last lesson, we learned how to talk about persons and things as in the expression, I read a book on films. So we can say in Korean, 영화에 대한 책을 읽었어요.
This time, let me pose a question to 선생님. Mm-hmm. 선생님, mm-hmm. 어제 뭐 했어요?
옛날 친구를 만나서 한국 영화에 대해서 이야기했어요.
An old friend. From how far back?
Well, I remember that I think it's been like about 10 years.
10 years.
Yeah, since I met her.
I see. Well, in this lesson, we'll learn expressions to talk about the duration of time from a point in the past all the way to the present. Okay, let's watch the clip then.
Michael 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요?
네, 어느새 1년이 지났어요.
저는 Michael 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요.
저도 그래요.
Michael 씨는 이제 한국말을 정말 잘해요.
아니요. 한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
걱정 마세요. 우리가 처음 만났을 때보다 훨씬 잘해요.
All right, let's very quickly go over what we just saw in the clip. Suji and Michael are having a conversation, and Michael mentions that it has already been 1 year since he came to Korea. He says, though, that it feels as if it's only been about 2 months. All right, at this, Suji says that Michael's Korean has really improved over that time period, but Michael says that he still has a lot to learn. Now, judging from these long sentences that Michael can now say, his Korean really seems to have improved. And Suji keeps on encouraging him and giving him words that he is doing really well in his Korean. All right then, let's get a check of the key expression in this lesson. We'll learn to express the duration of time from a point in the past to the present. Now, before we go straight to those expressions, let's go over some simpler phrases or simpler words that we will need to learn them. Please listen carefully to 선생님.
지나다, 지나다, 되다, 되다, 넘다, 넘다, 결혼하다, 결혼하다, 태어나다, 태어나다.
Michael 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요?
한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
At the beginning of the conversation, Suji asked Michael if it has already been 1 year since he came to Korea. How does she ask this in Korean?
마이클 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요?
수지 compliments Michael and says that his Korean language skills have really improved. But Michael says that it has already been 3 years since he started learning Korean, but he still has a long way to go. How did he say this in Korean?
한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요. 한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
Notice that the expressions spoken by the two people contain the expressions 온지 and 시작한지, that is a niun sound followed by the word 지.
When we want to talk about something that started in the past and continue to the present time, we have to attach the expression 니은지 to the verb stem for the word that denotes the action taken, which is followed by expressions related to the time frame. The word 만에 that we have learned in our previous lesson is similar and is placed after the number for time and is used to talk about a point after a certain period is over. But you have to remember that they deal with the different meanings though.
Now, how would we ask a question that calls for such an answer? Now, let's ask 선생님 for this.
마이크 씨가 한국에 온 지 얼마나 지났어요? 마이크 씨가 한국에 온 지 얼마나 지났어요?
All right, this time we're going to practice attaching the expression 니은지 to verb stems. So please listen and repeat after 선생님.
미국에 갔다가 오다. 미국에 갔다가 온 지. 싱가포르에 다녀오다. 싱가포르에 다녀온 지. 결혼하다. 결혼한 지. 태어나다. 태어난 지.
This time we're going to practice some complete sentences along with some verbs.
미국에 갔다가 온 지 이제 20년이 되었어요. 싱가포르에 다녀온 지 벌써 한 달이 넘었어요. 오늘 우리가 결혼한 지 꼭 10년이 되었어요.
It's really quite simple. All you have to remember is to attach the expression 니은지 to the verb stem. That's all you have to remember. This time, let's go over some questions and answers with what we have learned. 우리가 만난 지 얼마나 되었어요?
우리가 만난 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요.
홍콩에 갔다가 온 지 얼마나 되었어요?
벌써 두 달이 지났어요.
It is time for us to learn some extra expressions. What was Michael's answer when Suji asked him whether it has already been 1 year since he came to Korea?
네, 어느새 1년이 지났어요.
Now the word 어느새 can be translated to mean in no time, and it is usually used when something happens much more quickly than we anticipated. Let's try this word one more time.
어느새 어느새
Now after this, Suji mentions that it only seems as if it's been 2 months since Michael came to Korea. How does she say this in Korean?
저는 마이클 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요. 저는 마이클 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요.
The word 겨우 means just or only, and it is a word that we can use when something is far less or far little than what we anticipated. Now, Michael goes on to say that his Korean skills are still far from what he wants it to be. Now, how did he say this in Korean?
아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
The word 부족한 comes from the adjective 부족하다, meaning to lack. And the word 점 that follows, literally translated, means point. So Michael is saying that when it comes to his Korean language skills, he is still lacking in many points. That is, he is still not good enough. Now, Suji goes on to say that Michael's Korean has improved enormously since they first met. Let's review this expression.
우리가 처음 만났을 때보다 훨씬 잘해요.
Now the word 훨씬 means a lot more or much more, and it is used here to emphasize the fact that Michael's Korean has really improved. All right, then let's get a wrap up of what we have learned in this lesson. We are going to go over the expressions one by one, as usual, along with the clip.
Michael 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요.
Michael 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요.
네, 어느새 1년이 지났어요.
네, 어느새 1년이 지났어요.
저는 마이클 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요.
저는 마이클 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요.
저도 그래요.
저도 그래요.
마이클 씨는 이제 한국말을 정말 잘해요.
마이클 씨는 이제 한국말을 정말 잘해요.
아니요. 한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
아니요. 한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
걱정 마세요. 우리가 처음 만났을 때보다 훨씬 잘해요.
걱정 마세요. 우리가 처음 만났을 때보다 훨씬 잘해요.
Here now is another look at the entire clip from the beginning once again. So this time, it is your opportunity to memorize those expressions.
마이클 씨가 한국에 온 지 벌써 1년이 되었어요?
네, 어느새 1년이 지났어요.
저는 마이클 씨가 겨우 두 달 전에 온 것 같아요.
저도 그래요.
마이클 씨는 이제 한국말을 정말 잘해요.
아니요. 한국말 공부를 시작한 지 벌써 3년이 지났지만 아직 부족한 점이 많아요.
걱정 마세요. 우리가 처음 만났을 때보다 훨씬 잘해요.
I'm afraid we have to close this edition of Let's Speak Korean. In this lesson, we learned how to talk about a duration of time from a point in the past all the way to the present. As in the phrases 졸업을 한지 and 결혼을 한지, that those are the expressions that we use in our lesson this time. Let's get a quick review with 선생님. 선생님, mm-hmm. 우리가 방송을 같이 시작한 지 얼마나 되었어요?
벌써 거의 반년이 되었어요.
그래요? 저는 겨우 한 달쯤 된 것 같아요. 그동안 우리 참 많이 배웠죠?
네.
네. All right. Well, I'm afraid that is all the time we have for this lesson. But we shall be back with another fun-filled lesson full of useful expressions next time. So join us then. 안녕히 계세요.